This video will highlight the basic operating procedures and processes to properly and safely operate the hydraulic winch on your Bandit hand-fed chipper. Before using the winch, operators must read and understand the manual, decals, and video. Operators must wear the proper clothing and safety gear, including hard hat with face shield, ear and eye protection, and gloves. Never operate the hydraulic winch while the wood chipper is detached from the towing vehicle, as the chipper may move during operation. The tires of the chipper will need to be securely chocked, and if a rear-mounted stabilizer is provided, place the foot pad down to the ground. Only winch material when the machine is located on flat ground, and never winch material that is located to the side of the machine. The winch is designed to pull wood material up to the chipper and not to be used for any other purpose. The winch line must always be stowed before chipping material. Properly stowing the winch line will eliminate the chances of the line accidentally being fed into the chipper. If the winch line is not properly stowed, the knives of the disc or drum can grab the line and pull it in at a high rate of speed, resulting in severe injury or death. All aspects of the winch operation should be performed by one person only. Do not, for instance, have one person operating the winch controls with another person placing or holding the winch line. The person holding the winch line could have their hand pinched if another person is operating the winch controls. Operators should never place themselves between the brush and the winch line while using the winch. Bandit currently offers two different winch options manufactured by Dynamic or Ramsey. Depending on the model, these winches may feature hydraulic or electric feed assist controls. Before operating the winch, place the chipper control bar in the stop position. If the machine has a dynamic winch, the handle should be moved down to place the winch in free spool. The handle should be moved up to engage the winch. If the machine has a Ramsey winch, the handle should be turned clockwise to free spool. To engage the winch, turn the handle counterclockwise while bumping the winch control handle until the winch is fully engaged. While the winch is in normal operation or free spool mode, the chipper feed system will not work and the light located at the top of the winch will illuminate. Once in free spool mode, pull the winch line to the material and attach the line securely. Always winch material towards the chipper with the butt end of the log first. Re-engage the winch as described in the previous steps. Ensure that no one is standing in the anticipated path of the winched material. Once confirmed, material can be winched up to the chipper. Depending on your machine, there will be two variations to control the activation and override of the winch. One version features a hydraulic valve, and the other utilizes an electronic joystick. To pull the material towards the chipper, either pull the hydraulic valve towards you or push the electronic joystick downward. Once the piece of wood is securely placed on top of the infeed hopper, return the winch to free spool mode. Unhook the line and rehook it at least 10 feet back of the first winch point. Place the winch in engage mode and use the hydraulic valve or electronic joystick to pull the piece up tight against the feed wheels. Once against the feed wheels, the feed control bar will need to be placed in the forward position. The operator can then use the feed assist function to momentarily override the feed system. This will allow the feed wheels to briefly turn, getting the piece started into the feed system. Note that the override can also be used to briefly raise the lift cylinder. Operators should attempt to securely engage the wood with the feed wheel while also ensuring the piece does not get past the feed wheels, staying away from the disc or drum. With the material firmly between the feed wheels, place the control bar in the stop position. The last step in the process is to unhook the winch line . Securely place it back on the storage hook provided and tighten the line so that the line docking station compresses towards the winch. If the winch line is not tight and the docking station is not fully compressed, the feed system will not operate. Once the line docking station is compressed, the machine is ready to begin chipping as normal. Operators will need to pull the control bar towards them for feed mode. After pulling the control bar, walk away to a safe distance during chipping. If further instructions on winch operation are needed, please consult the operator's manual or consult with an authorized Bandit dealer.